أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين. So continuing with our discussion on the Bismillah, in this video we're going to look at three names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first is the name Allah. And the first discussion concerning the name of Allah is what its linguistic root is. And broadly speaking, there are two opinions. The first is that it is with the meaning of the one that is worshipped. So it comes from an original meaning of abada, which means to worship, but meaning here of course the one that is worshipped. And the second opinion is that it comes from bewilderment. And so again that would mean that the name Allah in its original form meant the one with whom the intellects are bewildered by his essence. However, Allamah Tabatabai, when he comes on to speak about the meaning of the name Allah, doesn't consider the discussion concerning the origin of the word to be important. What is important for Allamah Tabatabai is that the name Allah is a designated name for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for God. But before we get onto that, Allamah Tabatabai explains that this word was in use before the advent of Islam. And for that he refers to two ayat of the Holy Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. So if you ask them who created them, they will say Allah. And of course here it's in reference to the people who at the time of revelation didn't believe in Islam, yet they refer to Allah as God. So this is to show that the word Allah existed at the time of the Holy Prophet and at the time of revelation. And in another verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَقَالُوا هَذَا لِلَّهِ بِزَعْمِهِمْ وَهَذَا لِشُرَكَائِنَا. So in this verse, the mushrikeen split between Allah and their other gods. But they still recognize Allah and they recognize other gods. And they use the word Allah. So now returning back to the issue of the name Allah being a designated term, Allamah Tabatabai stipulates that it is a designated term for the one who has all of the beautiful names and all of the beautiful actions that follow on from those beautiful names. The superabundant essence that is all perfection. And for this reason, the name Allah is not like the other names. The name Allah can be described, but it cannot be used in a descriptive sense. So for example, you can say Allah the Most Merciful, but you cannot say the Most Merciful Allah, here in the sense of an adjective. Because as you know, in order to describe something, that thing has to be established. So for example, you can say Ali the Brave, but grammatically it's incorrect to say the brave Ali. So for Allamah Tabatabai, the name Allah is a name which is designated for the essence of the necessary existent which contains all of the attributes of perfection. But of course he also concedes that if you don't accept his view in this regard, then the meaning of Allah is he who is worshipped or he whose essence bewilders the intellects. So this is as far as the discussion on the name Allah goes in Tafsir al-Mizan. But of course there is much more discussion in other books.